In this tutorial, I'll demonstrate how to watermark a photo or a batch of photos in PaintShop Pro 2018. A watermark is simply a small image or piece of text that you overlay onto a photo. This image usually has a transparent background so that it will be subtle on the photo. Adding a watermark is a great way to advertise or claim ownership of your work and can also help prevent piracy. In this video, I'll cover creating a watermark image, adding the watermark image to a photo, and adding a watermark to multiple images at once. The first step in watermarking is to create the actual watermark image. In this example, I want to create a logo comprised of an icon and text. In PaintShop Pro, I have my edit workspace open, and I have an icon image already prepared. This icon is comprised of black shapes against a transparent background, which means it's a PNG file. Later in this tutorial, I'll show how to save an image as a PNG and make the background transparent. But I want my final watermark to appear in white, which works better than black against the background of most photos. The tool I'll use to fix this is Color Replacer, which is part of the Lighten Darken tool flyout. In the Materials palette, the foreground color should be white, and for the color I want to change, I could manually change the background to black. Or, to match the exact color in the image, I can press Ctrl while right-clicking on any black area. I can now paint over the areas to change, or just click the Replace All Pixels icon. Now I'm ready to create my watermark logo, which will be a new image. I'm choosing File, New, and setting a size of 300 by 300 pixels and a resolution of 150. The background here will be transparent. I'll drag the layer of the icon image onto the blank one. To resize, I'll activate the pick tool and use the drag handles. I can center the icon by choosing Objects, Align, Center in Canvas. Now for the logo text. The text tool is down here, and I'll set my font and size. I want a white font color and zero stroke width, which means the letters will have no outlines. To create the text, I'm clicking on the image and typing two letters, then double-clicking to finish. It's a bit hard to see because it's white text on a transparent background. But now I can resize and center. To save this as my watermark image, I'm choosing File, Save As. To maintain the transparent background, the file type should be PNG. I'm assigning a name and saving. Now I can close both of these images. Now let's see how to apply this watermark. I'm using File Open and browsing to this flower photo. From the main menu, I'm choosing Image Watermarking. There are three options here. Embed Watermark enables you to add a Digimark image. This is a paid digital watermarking service. Read Watermark identifies a Digimark watermark. The option we want to use here is Visible Watermark. Click Browse to find the saved PNG image. I have Preview on Image checked so I can see what the watermark will look like. I can set it to tile repeatedly, or appear just once at the center, or appear in one of the four corners. I'll place the watermark in the lower right corner, use the size slider to make it a bit larger, adjust the opacity, and add a small embossing effect. I can increase the preview zoom with my scroll wheel and drag the mouse to pan to the right spot to check how the watermark looks. After applying, here's my watermark. If I want to make changes, I can use Ctrl-Z to undo, then go back to Image Watermarking, Visible Watermark, and adjust the settings. Now let's see how to apply a watermark to multiple photos at once. I have several flower photos saved in this folder called Flowers. This watermark will be a proof marker. I'm creating a new watermark image at the same size as before, this time not using a transparent background. For the sake of demonstrating how to change a background to be transparent, I'll make this one dark blue. The text has the same properties as before, white font, no stroke. I'll change the font to something plainer and the font color to a medium gray. Then I'll click here and type proof. After double-clicking, I'm increasing the size and rotating. Now when I save this image as a watermark, I need to define the dark blue background as transparent. After File, Save As, I'm clicking Options, then Run Optimizer. In the Optimizer, I'm opening the Transparency tab and choosing the option to match color. I'm making sure that I can see the watermark image behind the Optimizer window and clicking the swatch to define the color to match. When the cursor is over the image, it changes to an eyedropper. I'm clicking in the dark blue background to pick up its color. After clicking OK, the preview window now shows the transparent background. I'm clicking OK to accept these settings, and I'm saving the PNG. Now we can start batch watermarking. You could create a script for this task, but watermarking and some other common tasks are already included as preset actions. I'm choosing File, Batch Process, and using the Add button to select all of the photos in the Flowers folder. Next, I'm choosing Batch Actions and adding a watermark. The visible watermark action will have the same settings as before, so I'll click the pencil icon to change the settings. I'll browse to the proof watermark, set it to tile, adjust the size, and increase the embossing effect. Watermarking isn't the only action I can batch process. I'll also add a picture frame to all of these photos. I'll edit this action and choose the frame called Platinum. There are also lots of other predefined scripts you could run, such as noise removal, sharpening, resizing to standard dimensions, and many more. If you plan on applying these batch process actions to other sets of photos, you can save the batch, then use Load Batch to call it up again later. Next comes output settings. First is the destination folder. I could keep them in the same folder as the original photos, but instead I'm going to place them in a subfolder called Proofs. For file name, I'm going to choose Rename and click Modify to specify the new file names. First, I need to include document name, which means the original file name will be included in the new file name. Clicking Add moves this to the Included box. I'll keep the original file names as they are. In addition, I want to add custom text, and this custom text should say Proof. I have a hyphen between the two options, and here's the example output. I can also set what happens with naming conflicts, choose the file format, and add security features. I can preview each image, including the new file name, then click Start. After the batch process is complete, I can open my organizer to the folder where I placed the proofs. I can drag one into the Edit workspace to see the new watermark and frame. This brings us to the end of this tutorial on watermarking. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial to follow along and find many other helpful tutorials for Corel PaintShop Pro.